Hello friends, welcome to Learner's Forum. So in last video, we saw about the conversion from decimal to octal. This video is all about conversion from decimal to hexadecimal. So as we know, the decimal to hexadecimal conversion is same as the other two conversions. Decimal is represented with base 10 and hexadecimal is represented with base 16. So let us see an example where we have to convert the given number 254 decimal number into its equivalent hexadecimal number. So the process is the same. We have to check if it is an integer or a fractional part. So here we do not have any decimal number, so it is a purely integer part. So we have to divide by the corresponding base value. So base is 16. So we have to divide the given number 254 by the value of 16. 16 into 15 will be 240, so the remaining will be 14. Now we have to draw the arrow mark from the last value, which is 15, which is moving upwards. So following the arrow mark, now let us write the equivalent hexadecimal value for the given number 254, which is 15, the first number, and next second number is 14. So now the direct value of hexadecimal cannot be left as such. We have to make a small replacement, that is, after the value of 9, from 10 to 15, it can be replaced with the alphabets from A to F. So 10 is replaced with A, 11 with B, 12 with C, 13 with D, 14 with E, 15 with F. We have 15, so it should be replaced with the value of F. Next 14, so it has the equivalent value E, so we have to write E in place of 14. So now we will get the equivalent hexadecimal value for 254 as FE to the base 16. So this is how we have to replace the given decimal number into its equivalent hexadecimal number. Next we will see it for the second example, where it has both the integer part and the fractional part. So 25.625, 25 will be taken under integer part. We have to divide it by the base value. So 16 ones are 16, remaining 9, and take the arrowhead moving upwards. Next, for fractional part, as per the rule, we have to multiply by its base value. So 0.625 into 16 will give the value as 10.0. So in front of the decimal we have 10, so we can keep that aside, and the remaining value after the decimal point, again we have to multiply by the corresponding base value. So 0, so 0 into 16 we will have 0. So we can stop the multiplication work with this. And now we have to draw the arrow mark, which is moving downwards. So for integer part 25, so for integer part we have got 19. And for fractional part we have got 10. Now we have to make the small correction, that is, 10 has to be replaced with the alphabet A as per the rule. So we can write it as 19.8, which is the equivalent value for the given number 25.625. Next, let us check, what if it has a different base other than the given values. So for example, this 27.4 has a decimal value, and as we know, the general number system types will be 2, 8, 10 and 16, as we have seen in the introduction part. So now just look at the example where we have to convert this decimal value into the equivalent value having a base of 4, which means it is not included in our basic types. So when question is of this particular format, then how to solve it will be a question. So let us solve, what if it has a different base. So again, we will follow the same procedure. We have to check for the integer part and fractional part. Integer part is 27 and fractional part is 0.4. So for integer part, we have to divide by its corresponding base value. The base given is 4. So we have to divide 27 by 4 now. So 4. 4 6 are 24. Remaining will be 3. We can keep that aside. Next, we can divide again by 4. So 4 ones are 4, remaining 2. 1 is less than 4, so we can stop the dividing process. And now we can trace the arrowhead by moving it upwards. So the integer part is over. Next we will move to the fractional part, which is 0.4. So we have to multiply by the corresponding base value, which is 4 here. So 0.4 into 4. Which is equal to 1.6. So in front of the decimal, 1 is there, so we can keep that aside. And the remaining value after the decimal is 0.6. So 0.6 into, again the base value is 4, which is equal to 2.4. Again in front of decimal we have 2 now, so we can keep that aside. The remaining value after decimal is 0.4. So again 0.4 into 4 will give you the value of 1.6. So in front of the decimal we have 1, we can take that aside. Remaining again 0.6. So once after this, it will be a repetitive value as we have seen in the first two steps. So we can stop with this and draw our tracing arrow, which is moving downwards. So we have completed for the integer and fractional part. So for 27.4 to the base 10, for integer part, we have got the value as 123, so 123. For decimal part, we have got 121, so 121 to the base 4. So this is the equivalent value for the given number. So this is how we have to convert if a different base is provided. So in case for any competitive exams, if you are provided with questions for converting into a different base value, then we might think like it is a mere attempt question or something like that. We have to solve it in this particular way and get the required answer.